doesn't matter the infirmity, the disease, the diagnosis that have been given to you by the doctors, by your physicians. God that we serve is a healing God. He has the power to heal. He has the power to deliver. And the healing power is going to move through the electronics, through the airwaves. It's going to touch you wherever you need healing the most. And the healing power is going to go through your head, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. It's going to go through your bones, your muscles. It's going to go through your ligaments. It's going to go through your tissues. It's going to go through your heart, your arteries. It's going to go through your kidney. It's going to go through your bones and the marrow. The healing power is going to flow through your whole being, and you're going to be whole. His power is not limited to location. His power is not limited to any individual. He can do anything if you can put your faith in him and ask him to come and intervene in your situation. He will do it quickly in the name of Jesus Christ. And if you read the Bible, the knowledge of the Bible is going to deliver you. The Bible says you shall know the truth will set you free. If you can dare to read the Bible, your understanding of the will of God, the plan of God for your individual life, for your family, will be unveiled to you. And as a result of that, the Bible says you shall be set free. The knowledge of this, the deliverance that God is talking about, is not just the knowledge of salvation from sin. It's a total deliverance. Which means the more you get to know God in any areas of your life, the more freedom you're going to enjoy in those directions of your life. Hallelujah. And like I said, I was used to be bothered about the communion in those days. Who can take the communion? I am not worthy enough to take the communion. Hallelujah. And I used to think that the bread has to be unleavened bread. If Jesus can put his blessing over the water, and the water can be turned into wine. If Jesus can put his blessings over the handkerchief of Paul, who can heal the sick and cast out demons. If Jesus can put his healing power over Peter's shadow to heal the sick as they come over the shadows of Peter. So the most important thing is the blessings of God that come through the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And which means God take over those elements. They cease to be ordinary things. They become supernatural things in the hand of God. It's faith in him. And the Bible says we walk by faith and not by sight. Remember, you have to receive it by faith, then you have it. And until you receive anything from God by faith, you cannot have that thing. No matter your belief in that, you have to receive it by faith. Your life can be over until God said it is over. And God cannot pronounce that over you. Hallelujah. Your business is not going to be over until God says it's over. Because God can't say that over you. See, there are certain things that cannot come from the mouth of God concerning your life. And those are the things that men says about you. God will say otherwise. That is why the Bible said, God said in his word, let the poor say, I am rich. And let the weak say, I am strong. He said, when they say, there's a casting down, then thou shalt say, there's a lifting up.
Come on, lift up your hands and lift up your voice and worship God. The presence of God is all over you in your house there. I want you to put your stretch out your hands towards the television and towards the TV, whatever you're watching from. I'm going to pray for you in the midst of this presence of God. We declare that this presence of God will be a canopy over your life. We declare that God will canopy himself over your workplaces. That just like the way the Bible says, he became the pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day. He became the pillar over the children of Israel on their journey to the promised land. As we move from this pandemic, from this lockdown, forward in life, I declare that God will be your tabernacle. His presence will be your canopy. In the name of Jesus Christ, we declare because you put your trust in God, you shall never be put to shame. You will be delivered miraculously. In the name of Jesus, I declare over your life, when they say there's a casting down, you shall say there's a lifting up for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare a sudden termination of your job is not permitted. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare that God will preserve your job, preserve your health, preserve your family. In the name of Jesus, the plan of the enemy concerning your life shall be turned in your advantage. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord will lift you up. The Lord will lift you up. The Lord will enlarge you in the name of Jesus Christ. All your dreams shall come to pass in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your name. We magnify you. in Jesus' name, and amen. Come on, put your hands together in your house, wherever you are. Just put your hands together in anticipation that God have heard your prayer, that God have answered your prayer, that God will fulfill all your dreams. Come on, put your hands together and give Him a shout in your house. Give Him a shout in your house. Give Him a celebration of victory. Wherever you are, He is a winning God. He will make you a winner. He will make you an overcomer. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.